Hello everyone, I'm Brandon with Lenovo, and I'm here today with the ThinkStation P300 Tower Workstation. Today we are going to be replacing the microprocessor and heatsink fan assembly. This process will take about 30 minutes, and you may want to have a little experience working with computers before attempting this. The only tool required will be a Phillips screwdriver. Before we continue, we need to make sure that we are protected from electrostatic discharge or ESD. Make sure to shut down the computer and disconnect all cables and accessories from the system. For further information, watch our Understanding Electrostatic Discharge video by clicking the link in the description. Now that we're ready, let's get started. In order to remove the cover, we must first remove two thumb screws. So now we just need to press inward on the release button, slide the cover towards the rear of the system, and remove it. Before removing the heatsink fan assembly, we must first disconnect the fan cable from the system board. Now we're going to loosen four capture screws in a cross pattern. Screw one, screw two, screw three, and screw four. Then we're gonna reach in, grasp the system fan, lift it up and out of the system. So now we're gonna press down and outward on the latch to open the processor door, and then reach in, grasp the processor by the edges, and lift it up and out of the socket. Here we have our replacement microprocessor. When replacing the processor, it is important that the marking on the processor and the marking on the system board are aligned. Once we have those two lined together, we just want to place the processor into the socket, close the processor door, and then press down and inward on the lever to lock it. If you're not replacing the heatsink, then you need to clean the excess thermal compound off of it. To do this, I have some isopropyl alcohol swabs. I'm just gonna hold the heatsink and gently, in a circular motion, wipe the excess thermal compound off of it. Allow the excess alcohol a few minutes to evaporate. Now we're going to apply the thermal compound. We just want to put about a pea-sized dab in the middle of the processor. If you've received a new heatsink with thermal compound pre-applied, you can skip this step. Now we're going to place the heatsink into the system using the screw holes for alignment. Then we're going to tighten four capture screws in a cross pattern. Tighten screw one halfway. And tighten screw two all the way. Then tighten screw one all the way. Tighten screw three halfway. Then tighten screw four all the way. Then tighten screw three fully. We tighten the heatsink this way in order to ensure that the thermal compound spreads evenly. And now we just need to reconnect the fan cable to the system board. Now when replacing the cover, you want to assure that the tabs on the cover align with the slots in the chassis. So you just line those up, and then press the cover forward until it locks. And finally, we need to replace two thumb screws.